Hello guys and welcome back to my channel. In this video I'm going to be talking about what are the types of manufacturing processes that are used in manufacturing automobile parts, and I'm going to be taking an example of a single component and explaining you which is the best manufacturing processes that can be opted for manufacturing the automobile parts. So I'm going to be taking an example of pistons, and there are almost three types of majorly used manufacturing process which are for manufacturing the pistons, and those are the casted, hyperotectic and forged pistons. The first type of manufacturing process that is used for manufacturing these automobile parts are casting, and this is the most common manufacturing process that is used for any automobile parts, and because it's more cost efficient and it gets the job done. Casting is something like when you are pouring a liquid metal into a mold which is in the shape of what the product we need. It means that whenever you want a desired shape, for example if you want a shape of a handlebar, so the mold will be in the shape of a handlebar, and the liquid metal is poured into the mold so that it can reshape the liquid metal into a hardened metal with a handlebar shape. That's the basic idea for casting. The problem with casting is the entire handlebar will not have the same strength from end to end. It means that whenever the metal cools down, it doesn't cool down in the same way from one point to another. It changes from every point whenever you try to cool down a metal from its molten or the liquid state. Whenever you try to get a solidified liquid metal, there are some air bubbles called dendrites, which are like tree-like structure formed inside the hardened metal, which is responsible for not so quite hard metal, and it decreases the strength of the metal. In short, it doesn't make your product or it doesn't make your part very strong, and it can break at any time because of there is no uniform strength in that metal, and if you apply too much of pressure on one end, it can sustain, but when the same strength or the impact is applied on the other end, which is of lower strength, it might break immediately within a second. So that's the reason why casting is not preferred so much in the performance field. The second type pistons which are used are the hyperotectic pistons. This process is mostly used for pistons only, and these are not used for the other parts of an engine or other parts of a bike. So this is only a piston technology that is developed, which is a crossbreed of both forged and casting. Hyperotectic pistons are nothing but taking a casted piston and adding some forged on top of it with a lot of silicon around it. So what basically the silicon does is whenever the piston is moving up and down, it creates a friction from the cylinder valves or the cylinder bore to the piston. So when this piston is moving up and down, it's because of the friction, it tends to heat up a lot. Silicon is made for that purpose, so that it can sustain the high temperature which is being produced inside the cylinder because of the combustion. So whenever this combustion takes place, the silicon makes the piston to cool down, and it reduces the temperature of the piston so that you can run the engine for at a very high RPM for a greater longer period. And these hyperotectic pistons are one of the most widely used performance part in every engine because it is both affordable and it is very good at performing. Third type is the king of all the parts manufacturing process, is being used, and the king of all the pistons which is used, and that being the forged pistons. So why forged pistons are so much of important in terms of performance engines whenever you are running at 14,000 RPM and running for a very long time. So in forging process, basically the forging process takes place like you are taking a metal and heating it continuously and reshaping it into the desired shape which we want as a product. For example, you are taking an piston, basically you are taking a metal and heating it number of times and cooling it number of times. In the same meanwhile, you are reshaping that metal into desired shape of that piston. So what this basically does is, whenever you are reshaping the metal, it means you are hammering it. Whenever you are hammering it or whenever you are reshaping the metal in terms of applying pressure or applying weight on the metal in the hottest form of the metal, so this tries to bring out all the air bubbles inside the forged piston. So basically there are no dendrites formed, and which means there are no tree-like structures that are formed inside the metal, and these metals are very much high performance parts which are used in very high performance engines. For example, the latest generation CBR Fireblade 1000RRR uses these forged pistons because there are a lot much stronger, there are a lot more pressure handle, and there is a lot more weight to it. So whenever you try to make a metal dense, and whenever you try to make a metal, compress it into a desired shape, so it means you are making the atoms to pack in as much as little space as possible, which means the lesser the space between the atoms, the greater the strength of the metal. That's the principle that's been used in forged pistons, and forged pistons are very highly recommended in any type of performance upgrades. No matter what you are building it, in terms of advantages of all these types of parts are, casting is the cheaper and the most affordable thing which you can afford and which you can opt for your build, or even if you are trying to make a modified version of the stock automobile you have. And hyperbaric pistons are only made for piston technology, so that's on your choice. If you find it in the market, you can use it, but I prefer you to go to a forged pistons. Anyway, you are upgrading from the stock casted to hyperbaric, which is not much of an upgrade. And the last is the forged parts. These are the king of every manufacturing process that has been used till now. And forged parts are very strong and they have very high impact strength, which means whenever it encounters an impact on it, it has very high impact strength, and it doesn't break or it doesn't let you off in the middle of any journey. Try to find as much as forged parts in an automobile, and that's it with this video, guys. If you find this video helpful, make sure you subscribe to my channel, and that's all with this video. Peace.